Our journey begins in Vincennes. Located on the Wabash River, Vincennes is about 130 miles southwest of Indianapolis. It's also home to Vincennes University, the oldest college in Indiana, and one of only two colleges in the country founded by a president. That president was William Henry Harrison. Also located in Vincennes is his Indiana home, Grouseland. When it comes to presidents, Harrison certainly was unique. Not only was he a United States president, but also an American military officer, politician, and the last president born as a British subject. Harrison was the first president to die in office at the age of 68, making him the oldest president to take office until Ronald Reagan in 1981. Harrison died on his 32nd day in office. Harrison originally gained national fame for leading U.S. forces against American Indians at the Battle of Tippecanoe. That battle took place against the Confederacy of Native Indian Warriors. One of Harrison's greatest personal achievements was Grouseland. Harrison bought over 300 acres of land before starting the development of his new home. Grouseland was the first brick home in Indiana and was built in a fortress style to deter and defend against any attacks by the many Native American tribes local to the area. This includes a working well, along with windows designed to give maximum visibility to oncoming attacks. Lisa Ice Jones is the director of Grouseland. She specializes in the history of Harrison as well as his former home.
Harrison was appointed by President John Adams in 1800 to become the new governor of the newly aligned Indiana Territory. He wasn't too excited to come out here to this vast territory that was largely unsettled by the Americans, but he was sent out here to do two very important jobs: to attract as many settlers to come here as he possibly could, and to treat with the Indians and obtain as much land for the new American government and its expansion as he could. And he did both of those jobs very well. Also, what he did very well is to build a very magnificent and showy structure. He basically had to come here to the territory and obtain the authority, make his presence known, make the presence of the American government here to be seen. So he had to really come and take that authority.
Inside, visitors get an up-close glimpse of life on the early frontier. Nearly all of the furnishings in the house are original to the property and were donated by the Harrison family. To build the home, they used all homemade materials, including all of the 400,000 bricks and hand-forged nails. And it was said to have cost $20,000, which would be about $500,000 today.
The walls are four bricks thick. That ensured safety. So the idea was that you couldn't shoot through the house, you couldn't burn it down. It was basically a haven of safety. We have a tourist legend here in one of the shutters in the dining room that there was actually a hostile shot through that shutter to try to assassinate Harrison when he was standing in front of the fireplace. Obviously, that was not successful. And had that been successful, we not only would have not had our ninth president, we also would not have had our 23rd president, because William Henry Harrison was also the grandfather of Benjamin Harrison, our 23rd president.
The Harrison Governor's Chair is of historical and modern significance to citizens of Indiana.
The governor's chair that we have in the bedroom upstairs at Grouseland has also been used during the last two gubernatorial inaugurations here in Indiana. Governor Daniels and Governor Pence were both inaugurated in that chair, and hopefully, maybe with the upcoming election, we'll put it to use again. So we have redubbed that chair the governor's chair.
Also housed here is the State Rifle of Indiana, declared in 2012 by Governor Mitch Daniels as the official state gun. This rifle is said to be over 200 years old and was made by Indiana's first sheriff, John Small. This gun is one of only six long rifles made by Small that has ever been found. Grouseland was added to the list of National Historical Landmarks in 1966. Visiting this stately mansion, we can also see some of the best structural designs in Indiana and some of the most priceless and unique artifacts as well.